Ready?
Yep.
All right, let's do it. What is up, everyone? Thanks so much for tuning in to the first official episode of. Well, I don't know yet. For now, it's just going to be B Street Testimony Podcast, yeah. Or something. I don't know what it is, but. Anyway, it's the first official episode. We have Ben Bryson with us.
What's up?
How do you feel about, is this your first podcast ever?
It's a really cool setup, I'll say that, and I'm looking forward to it.
Do you feel kind of excited?
Yeah, or? I am excited. I've never been on a podcast, so I've always wanted to be. My friends and I have talked about doing one just for fun, but never really got around to it. So
yeah, I can say that this has been pretty exciting for me as well.
Yeah.
So because I haven't done this either, so it's just kind of fun to have the stuff around and I don't know, do it. So, well, if you don't know the purpose of why we're here, it is really just to kind of give. A platform for people to share testimonies, the way that Jesus has been working in their life. And so there's a video that you can find on the YouTube channel where I kind of explain why that's become so important to me, and how I hope that people come in here to share stories will really hope to encourage conversation, for people to be able to have conversation about Jesus and the hope that lies within them because of it. So I think let's just kind of, I don't know, jump right into this and see how it goes, and we'll go from there.
Awesome.
So start out by telling us a little bit about you. Who are you? Where do you go to school?
All right.
What do you do for fun?
My name's Ben Bryson. I'm a senior at Groomer High. I enjoy all things sports, so I love Clemson football. I swim for my high school and for Sales swim team. I enjoy just hanging out with my friends and just having fun, doing a bunch of different things. You know, whatever comes to our mind, we just go and just do it. Yeah, because why not? Nothing bad, of course, but only good stuff.
Yeah, so. Especially with the church, only do right.
Exactly.
Got it. So first question that I want to ask is, where would you say that your story with Jesus begins?
Personally, I grew up in a Christian family, so it's always been an aspect of my life, in a sense. I was always taught, I went to a Christian school when I was in elementary school, so it's always been something that's been taught to me. But my true relationship with him kind of started a little bit after confirmation. I was able to actually realize the bigger picture of things, through one of the retreats that we went on for Buncombe Street.
Mm-hmm.
It just helped me realize it's bigger than what I've always heard through stories and stuff like that. So.
Gotcha. Are there any specific conversations or maybe you had a conversation with someone about Jesus early on that sticks out to you, or was it because, you did grow up in a Christian family that there were so many it's just kind of
Of course, my parents, always talked to me about Jesus, but, I guess my siblings were probably more influential because I kind of looked up to them a lot. So, when my sister talked to me about Jesus, it's, a whole different, aspect than my parents talking to me about it, because I don't know. I guess it's just that,
maybe
child thing,
more on a different level.
It's more something like that, you just how when you're a kid you just don't want to listen to your parents, I guess.
Yeah, well, and you definitely communicate with your siblings
better.
Different than you do with your parents.
Yeah,
especially as a kid, because they're telling you what to do.
Yeah, exactly, and you never just want to listen to them.
Yeah. All right, so tell us about a time when you remember experiencing the presence of God for the first time. So it's like you were at this place or whatever it was, and you just remember being there and going, this is what the presence mm-hmm. of God feels like. I know that I'm in it.
So it's that, it was a while ago. It was at Winter Jam, I guess.
Yeah.
For that, it's like, if y'all don't know what Winter Jam is, it's like a big Christian concert with a bunch of different artists who come and sing, and it's just like, I don't know if you've been, I'm sure you've been.
Oh, yeah.
It's just a crazy experience. For sure. Like, you definitely feel that presence of God when you're there and everyone's singing along, and it's just like crazy how it, you just feel in that moment. So
yeah, that's one of the things that I guess in the most recent series at this time that we've been talking through with the youth is the faith in an anxious world. And one of the things that we keep going back to is how as believers we're meant to be in community, mm-hmm. right? And at Winter Jam there are tons of people, and yeah. so it's just like this one big community, and it's hard not to mm-hmm. see the presence of God yeah. at some point in time, because it's like, how can you not when you're living out, or when you're a part of the faith in the way that it's maybe intended? Mm-hmm. So that's cool.
Yep.
All right, so think about a time where you've had a doubt or doubts about God. And so, you know, one of the things that we're trying to get across with this question is, you know, that it's okay mm-hmm. to have doubts. Like, we're human, we have doubts. Sometimes the stuff that we talk about in faith is kind of like, is that really
yeah.
how that works? Or, you know, so is there a time that you can remember that you're okay to share? Did it get resolved? Is it unresolved?
So, I always just, like, every once in a while, just, like, have doubts that just pop up into my head. Because you're just like, how is this even possible? Like, how is it even a reality that it could be, like, a thing?
Yeah.
With there just being, like, a greater being out there. One specific...
For sure.
Yeah, one specific example that, like, I really thought about it was, like, how in the world are we living on a planet like that allows everything for us to survive when literally everywhere else in the universe is just like, you can't live there.
Yeah.
And it just kind of blew my mind to think about, like, how is that possible that he just shaped it all together? Like how do you do that almost?
How do you do that, and why did you just make it
yeah,
one?
Yeah, exactly.
Why is it just one place?
Yeah, exactly.
So where have you come to with it?
I don't know. That's still so, like, just hard to think about in a way. Like, really thinking about it. I guess he just wanted a group of people to be able to, like, love him and praise him, I guess. I don't know. But at the same time, I don't know if he needs that either.
So no, I think that's actually really cool
yeah.
That you say that, because I think that is exactly
yeah.
why he even put us here to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
Is, you know, he was up there and he was like, you know what? I want people to praise me.
Mm-hmm.
And there's so many bunny trails we could take with that, because it's like, well, that sounds kind of arrogant. Yeah. But at the same time, we're not talking about, you know, humans. We're talking about a perfect, righteous, holy God.
Exactly.
You know,
yeah.
And so, but yeah, I think you've pretty much hit that one on the head mm-hmm. as to why it's like,
yeah,
why we're here.
And it's so, it's so big too. I wonder if there's anyone. If there's anything else there that
I know,
created, that always makes
the universe is huge.
Like, there's so much unexplored.
Yeah, I think part of that is being okay, you know, being okay with faith in a sense that there are going to be things that go unseen or not understood. And, you know, that's one of the things that I think you can talk about and maybe dream or vision or whatever. But at the same time, you kind of come to it and it's like, if I don't ever understand this, it's okay.
Yeah.
You know, it's not going to shape how I view God. It's just one of those things that in my small human mind that I can't seem to grasp.
Yep.
Cool. all right. So we, what was it? I guess it was 2 weeks ago now where we got together, talked about what your favorite Bible verse was, and you said, let me get back to you. So I'm wondering if this is, did you come up with one that you know anything about or that you like? Or,
well, I know at the last in-house we went over one that I really enjoyed. It was about the story of like Jesus walking on water during the storm while they were on, while all the, I guess it was his disciples while they were on the boat.
Right.
And we just went like in depth on what that really meant. And like, it was more like, and you're like, it, of course the broad like idea of what that story was about is like, even during your craziest times, if you like go to Jesus, he can make things calm, I guess, or just help you through those things. But then we went into a deeper meaning of it through like he's just always, he's always there, even during your good times and bad. Not just, you don't just need to call upon him during those bad times, but also during your good times, you need to go to him as well. So,
yeah, I think that kind of brings it in and shapes it into more of a relationship.
Yeah,
when you view it in that sense.
Yeah.
So, were you able to take any of those conversations and make it practical for you? Like during the week, have you seen it played out yet?
Definitely. So, funny enough, I had my regional swim meet last night. And I did awful. Like I was supposed to do a lot better than I did. Like the 50 freestyle was my like event, and I got first in it last year, so I was supposed to repeat this year. And for some some reason, not even first. Like I disqualified.
Oh,
yeah. So I was nervous like the whole day leading up to the meet, and I don't really ever get nervous for the meets. And so I false started because my leg twitched on the block, and when you do that, it's a false start. And I wasn't really bothered by it, even though I was like really nervous for the whole day, because I knew it was out of my hands a little bit.
Yeah.
But like the whole rest of the week was good, and I was just like my relationship with him like throughout that was the same. It kind of helped me with having the relationship with him when it didn't go well, almost.
It was like, just because this one thing happened doesn't mean that my whole world is falling apart. It doesn't mean that I'm not gonna you know, get back up and try again. Like I am gonna get back up and try again. That's what we were talking about, because didn't we talk about the which one is it now? Philippians
4:13.
I can do all things through Christ.
How there's a lot, it's a lot deeper than just.
It's not about, you know, because I think so many people in some cases would like see that situation and say, you can do all things through Christ, and meaning like you can qualify or you can win the race or whatever it is. And now here you are like, but I didn't. I didn't qualify, you know. And so to be able to see that situation and go, you know, I didn't get the outcome that I wanted, but I can still praise God and, you know, show his character in that. I think that's what the verse is at. And so that's just cool to hear that even after we had that conversation and, you know, your conversation from in-house, just to see that play out practically is like, dude, that's awesome. That's really cool. All right. So how would you say that your faith has changed in the last year?
Oh, man. Well, I guess with the whole COVID thing, it's been kind of, it's been different in a way.
All of our faith has changed.
We haven't been able to go to church, so I haven't been able to necessarily, and we haven't really been able to be around people either, so you can't surround yourself with the people who, like, help you through your faith and things, so it's a little tough, but, like, being able to have just little reminders throughout the day, if it's from, well, from my Young Life leader, sometimes I get text messages that's just like, hey, how are you doing? Even just that simple of a thing, like, help me remember, like, to stay in my faith a little bit more than what I probably would have. It was tough because you don't really know what's going on in the world and with everything that's going on. So, like, you have questions about why certain things are happening. And you just got to dig into the word a little bit to really find an understanding. Even if you don't find it, you'll eventually get there probably. So.
Yeah, well, I think the more you search for stuff, you know, the more God will at some point reveal more of what's going on, even if it's not, you know, like a an exact answer to this thing that you're wondering about. You know, he might reveal more of his character over here and say, this is what, this is who I am. Even though that doesn't really answer your question, don't worry about that, I got it, you know.
Yeah, that's like one of the craziest parts about, like, faith with Jesus is somehow he always finds a way to answer your questions in like some form.
Yeah.
Like, if it's through a scripture in the Bible or if it's through someone else doing something, I feel like eventually he always finds a way to, like, answer those questions that you have.
Yeah, and I think it's important to be you know, we have to be pursuing him in order to be able to hear it, you know, because we're told, like, sometimes he speaks in the still small voice, and it's like, if you're not listening for a small voice, you might miss it.
Yeah.
So, gotcha. So what would you say has been a pivotal moment in your relationship with Christ?
Oh, man. Pivotal moment in my relationship with Christ. So, I guess there's always, like, we have classic, like, retreats and or events for church that always, like, are, like, a refresher almost for like, your relationship with God. But I want to say those are my pivotal moments, because sometimes you're on that spiritual high and then it just goes right down, and you to really, like, have those pivotal moments, you have to, like, use what you got in those retreats.
Yeah, you have to, like, afterwards, let it play
out, and sometimes that's hard to do. I don't necessarily think my pivotal moment has come yet with God, which is something that I think should be talked about more, probably, because I feel like with, we kind of hit on this last year, I walked with Christ a little bit. The fact that you don't have to have that aha moment, like, it, your relationship with Christ, like, doesn't always have to be some low of low and then, like, you hit rock bottom and then somehow find Jesus and it turns, like, you completely around it. You can be just, like that same level the entire time and it not happen yet. So
Well, and that's kind of what we're talking about. That's why we're trying to set this up this way is, you know, talking about the not everyone has a tragic life event in the way that we think of tragic life events. And so, you know, because that's one of the things I'm trying to explain is, like, whenever we step into faith with Jesus, we literally move from death to life. And that is, like, tragic and dramatic and you have gone from death to life. And so that's big, right?
That's probably the biggest thing.
But at the same time, there's still certain, like, landmarks in our life where we go, Jesus really, he spoke in a way that I hadn't understood yet. Like, I didn't know that he could communicate that way, and this is a landmark for me. And so there's different things like that. And so
sometimes it's really hard to look at it in that way too.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sure I've had so many moments that I just can't think of because I just didn't. I'm not thinking in my head, oh, this is the way he's communicating to me.
Right.
And I guess that's like coming down. That's like going back to thinking in a smaller aspect of things. Like, you really want to, like, dive deep into certain ways he communicates.
Yeah.
Because it's hard to tell sometimes.
Like, oh, for sure. No doubt. Yeah, I'll be excited to hear more of where you think he steps in.
Yeah.
That'll be cool. All right. Okay, so what are some lessons that you're learning right now?
Well, yeah, going back to, like, what I said about last night, it's just kind of, like, patience and, like, how he does things, almost.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's a pretty recent lesson.
Yeah, that is a very recent lesson.
Fresh.
Yeah. You know, he, even though sometimes it seems like you don't understand why he does certain things, like, he knows, I guess he knows, like, just how to help you through those certain things.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think he wants bad things happening to people. Like, I don't think that's a part of his, like, what of his doing. But I think he wants to help you through those bad things, which is, like, why it's so important to be, like, good with your, like, to have good faith with him and a good relationship. So.
Yeah. No, I think that's a huge point, because he didn't create a world with evil in it.
Yeah.
Right? Like, he created a perfect world. He said it was good. He said it was good. And then he said it was very good. And so he wanted it to be very good, perfect and righteous. And then we messed it up.
Yep.
So, all of this is him working out his redemption. Yep. And so for you to be able to see that, like, that's huge. That's a big deal.
Yeah.
So that's cool. Okay. So just a couple more questions, really, maybe just one more, but who would you say are some of your biggest role models? And then, just to kind of go along with it, have you ever thought about God's calling in your life?
Okay. So of course, like, my biggest role models are, like, of course, my parents and my dad especially. Like, he's always taught me, like, how to be a good man and, like, how to treat people respectfully and treat everyone how you want to be treated, you know.
Yeah.
The classic, is that the golden rule, I guess? Or no?
Is what?
Is that the golden rule?
Golden rule?
Yeah.
Do unto others is you would have them do unto you or something like that.
I don't really have any celebrity role models because
which
I don't know
fine.
If that's necessarily healthy, like, in my opinion, like, because everyone messes up. Like, you don't want to be so disappointed when, like, this, you idolize this, like, big, like, celebrity, and then they mess up, and then it, like, destroys you. Like, that's not really my
Yeah, and I know for thing. Me, whenever I ask about role models, you know, and nothing against celebrities as people or anything, but I'm more interested to hear about who's working in your life, like right now, like your dad. The fact that he's a role model in your life is like, you know, he's someone that you actually see and talk to every day. And, you know, that relationship is going to change, especially once you graduate high school and go into college, you know, because now you're not necessarily going to be under his roof all the time, you know? And so it's not that you're not his son anymore. It's just you kind of become two adults and it takes on more of a friend relationship. And so it's, you know, how does that look different in the role model that he is? And for sure, not to idolize anyone, but you know, people have different effects on you. And so it's cool to hear how those kinds of things grow as well. Yeah. So yeah, not that celebrities are bad, but it's just more interesting to hear about who's acting in your life right now. And so God's calling. Have you ever given that any thought as to what he might be calling you to do?
Oh man. I mean, I have, and like, that's something I struggle with. Like, I have no clue like what the future holds. Like, I have no clue. And that's something like I really want to figure out, but I know it's something that I can't figure out. It'll just like happen. Because you know, now like as being a senior, like everyone asks like, oh, what are you going to major in college? Like, what do you want to do for the rest of your life? I'm like, I don't know. Like, I have no clue.
Yeah.
Like, even like with where I want to go to school, like it's hard to just like figure out like what you like, how you're going to get to where you want to be and stuff like that. So
yeah, I know I don't necessarily have a great answer for that one either. So,
but I think
you're in a good place right now.
I think, yeah, I'm in a good place right now. And I guess God's calling is always for us to share his testimony with other people.
For sure.
So I guess I want to do that to my best ability. But when it comes to the bigger picture of like what I'm
going to, where am I going? Doing, what am I doing?
I don't know. So
cool. Man, well, thanks for taking some time to talk through that stuff, and
thanks for having
and share where God is working in your life. So I guess a couple of the last things that I would say is that as far as B Street Youth goes, if you attend B Street Youth or whatever, know that Ben has one more year. One more year in B Street Youth.
That's so sad, dude. I feel like I've been here for so long.
I know. Doesn't mean you can't come back.
Yeah, yeah.
Just not as a youth. Once you're done being a youth, that's it. So if you want to talk to him, ask him questions, talk about faith together, or ask more about his story. Once we start coming back to the church, find him and talk to him.
Yes, I love talking to people, especially if I don't know you.
It's cool stuff.
Yeah.
So
feel free. I'm not scary at all.
Yeah, and even if he looks scared at first, or scary at first, you just kind of, why you look scary? Yeah. And maybe that's your icebreaker or something.
Yeah.
All right, so with that being said, what do you have going on this weekend? What are you doing?
Oh, man, I've got the SAT tomorrow. Not looking forward to it, but also looking forward to it because it's my last time taking it. So
the last time taking it. Yep. Do you know how many times you've taken it?
No.
But this is the last one.
Yep. So let's hope I
last
can kill
set,
it.
Last set, right?
Yep. Cool. So yeah, I got that tomorrow, and then got to get prepared for state swim meet next week, and hopefully
gotta
get
qualify.
My head back in the game, not mess up. So
cool.
Yep.
Well, we will let you get to all those things. Thanks for tuning in. We'll look forward to the next episode of Testimonies at B Street. We really need to figure out a name for this.
I like B Street Podcast.
Just B Street Podcast. Yeah, just keep it simple. Cool. That's probably what
or
it should
you could
be.
Call, I mean, it could be like, I don't know, talking with Jesus, but that's
I know,
just
it's
so
kinda,
cliche.
It's kind of tough to like think through a name and not be weird about it. Yeah, exactly. That's weird.
Be sure your podcast is good.
All right. Well, until next time, we're out.
See ya.